So in this video, we're gonna take a look at how you can create a beautiful and captivating Instagram carousel for your profile all within Canva. And I'm also gonna be taking you through how I find inspiration for my designs while browsing through Instagram, because it can be quite hard to start from scratch with this as a total beginner. And for that reason, I have also created a template for you that you can use to just really quickly add to your Canva library just by clicking on the link. And you can then follow along with this entire tutorial without having to actually create the canvas and do all the nitty-gritty detail-y type things. So make sure to check it out there, add it to your Canva library, and let's get creating. So firstly, let's quickly talk about how to find inspiration for your designs from actual live carousels, not just the designs that you see within Canva, because I find them to be quite limited. Often the templates just have one post or a couple of posts, not sort of these lengthy, you know, 10 image carousels like you see on Instagram sometimes. So whenever you are on Instagram and you see a carousel like this one from Dane Walker, I already know he's a great person to follow for carousel inspiration. If you see a carousel just coming across your feed like this, just hit the save icon and hold it down and you'll actually be able to create a folder. So you'll be able to just create a new folder to say carousel inspiration. So I already have one for this particularly that I use for my own carousel inspiration, but you can create your own and then you can just save any carousels to this particular folder. I do the same thing with videos and reels, so everything's really nice and organized. I also do this by clients, so if you ever have clients that are in a particular industry and you're doing some research, it can be quite hard to actually just take screenshots of everything and keep things organized. So I like to create these kind of folders all within my Instagram account. That's really easy for me to refer back to whenever I'm looking at creating something. The other thing that you can do if you're starting from complete scratch is just looking at these kind of hashtags that I've got here, like carousel, carousel designs, carousel post. Now, keep in mind, if you're looking at the hashtag carousel, you will just look at some photos of people on actual carousels, because it is not just carousel posts. So there will be some, you know, carousel chandeliers and all those sorts of things, but there will be some amazing carousel posts that you can draw inspiration from, like this one over here. And for extra bonus points, I do, you know, I like to draw inspiration from other people, not copy directly, but if you have a bit of a harder time looking at something and trying to replicate it without sort of having it right there in front of you with the entire, you know, carousel side by side, then what you can do is take screenshots and then, you know, add this to your phone so that you can bring it into Canva and then use it for inspiration for your design. So you can just kind of take a screenshot of each of the carousel posts like this and then crop it to the actual image. Now, I really, really want to preface this by saying do not copy people's designs exactly, but it can be beneficial to sort of have it all beautifully laid out in Canva so you can be looking at it as you're designing rather than having to continuously go back to your phone, especially when we're talking about going back to Instagram, which is a time sucker when it comes to trying to create and spend time on Instagram at the same time. So it can be easier to just take a couple screenshots and have this kind of carousel inspiration folder on your phone so that you can really quickly draw back to that. All right, now let's jump into Canva and start designing some stuff. So the file we'll be working with within Canva is actually designed for vertical graphics, 5 vertical graphics for your carousel post. And that's because a lot of the carousels on Instagram, like these ones from Dane Walker, are actually vertical graphics. They're not just square posts, because it gives them a little bit more real estate as they're scrolling through your feed. And it will allow us to also design something that has overlapping elements, like this A donut here, which actually looks like it's moving from one graphic to the next. So that's exactly what we're going to be designing within Canva today. So the way I've set up this template is essentially just 5 1080p blocks. So the template is 5,400 by 1350, and that's just because this graphic is 1350 tall, but the actual bottom there is just 5 blocks of 1080, because all Instagram graphics are 1080 pixels wide, so it's just 5 blocks of that, so that I can design all the graphics all at the same time this way. So if you were gonna go over to resize, if you're on a Canva Pro account and you wanted 6 Instagram carousels, you can just add 1080 to this 5,400 pixels width. So that would make it 6,580, and that would just increase it by one 1080 pixel width post, if that makes sense. So you can copy and resize my template, or you can go to custom size and create your own by just doing multiples of 1080 in your width. So if I was designing two posts as a carousel, it would be 2160 would be the width, and the height would either be 1080p if it was a square graphic, or 1350 if I was going for a vertical graphic like the one we're designing here. Now, when it comes to these purple guides here, these are not going to show up on the actual design. They're just there to guide me so I know where that split is going to be of my five graphics. Under file, you want to make sure you have rulers and guides switched on, which will allow you to essentially click and drag these guides to where your graphics are going to split up. So you want to have it at 1080, 2160, and so on and so forth in multiples of 1080. And then at any point, just go over to file and switch the guides on and off so that you can check how your design is looking without the lines, or you can use the keyboard shortcuts there as well, because keep in mind, these are not going to print on your actual designs there. And I've also got an additional little guide here for you, is to design within the yellow boundary of your first graphic, because this is what's going to appear on your Instagram profile. It's just for the first graphic because that's going to show up on your feed. When you're scrolling through Instagram, you see the square image. So you want to make sure all your text and your important stuff is within this square boundary for the very first graphic within your carousel. For inspiration for your designs, you can either bring in your own, or you can search for things like carousel multi-page, which is my search term hack for finding templates that have multiple pages within them and then filtering that by Instagram post. So you'll see this has 7 pages. A lot of these will have at least 3. Some will still be single post, but this seems to be a really good way to get inspiration from templates that are designed to have multiple posts within them, which makes it easier to work with them. Whereas if you just look for Instagram posts, it'll just kind of give you one template, one image designs, which can be quite difficult to go off of. So these are my kind of personal favorites because they're quite minimalistic. They have a lot of these organic round shapes in them. And then you can essentially just copy over some of the elements from these Canva templates that you really like, that you want to use in your design. So just click and drag, and then hit Command C if you're on a Mac, or Control C on a PC to copy these over and bring them into your design. So I would just delete this for the time being. We'll bring it back in at the end just to check that the first image in our carousel is optimized to show up beautifully in our feed, but I would come in and just change my background color to whatever color I want it to make sure that I'm optimizing as I go, and then just paste in some of these elements from the graphics from the other templates that I found inside of Canva. Now, of course, you can just design from scratch by bringing in the screenshots of different carousels you found on Instagram and trying to replicate those kind of styles, or just starting from scratch by going off of ideas that are in your head. That's totally fine as well. But if you do want to just shortcut this for yourself, especially if you're a beginner and you don't really know where to start, this can be a really easy way to just kind of get a few ideas going. I'm just going to speed a few things up here because I'm just going to be copying and pasting different elements of the templates that I found in Canva and just adding them into my design, making sure everything is really nice and aligned. This is another benefit of doing things in a row like this, where you can actually see how your graphics are going to play together in terms of the height of your text and all the different elements, and making sure that when someone's scrolling across their feed, everything looks really, really nice and cohesive, which is really hard to do when you're designing each graphic individually, as Canva have it set up with the other templates that we've seen, where, you know, each graphic is its own individual design. It's hard to know, you know, where's the text on this one versus this one. We're able to do this really beautifully in a row like this, where you can align everything with the text in the previous graphic, and it makes it really nice and professional. And I'm just going to copy a couple of last few things over here and making sure everything is nice and aligned. And at some point, you're going to get to a point in your design process where you want to add your own flair. You might want to add your own images or things like that. So looking at the frames and the elements tab and trying to add in a couple of different frames that you can place your own images into can be a really fun way to spruce up your carousel, or add images of yourself in as well, whether you're on the Canva free or pro plan. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to add an image of myself that I brought into my library, into my uploads folder earlier, and just drag that into my frame here. And then you want to head on over to styles. If you're on the Canva Pro account, if you're on Canva Free, you can manually adjust the colors of your carousel. But on the Pro accounts, you can cycle through a few different styles within your brand kit color palettes. If you don't know how to set this up, just within your Canva dashboard in the brand kit section, you can set up a few different color palettes there, and they'll show up in the styles and your design documents, which will allow you to cycle through a few different options for what your carousel could look like, which again will give it that nice, beautiful, cohesive look that's already beautifully branded with your existing colors. You may need to tidy up a few things at the end because obviously it's never 100% with how you want it to look, but that's looking really, really nicely. I would then adjust the fonts either within the style section or manually if I'm maybe going for a particular look. And finally, I would also make sure that everything looks really good on the mobile version. So when you send this to your phone, make sure that all the fonts and the text and everything is large enough for people to read really clearly. There's enough contrast between the text and the background and all that good stuff. And then the last step, of course, is to bring in the element from my first initial template there and adjust the transparency so you can see what's going to be in the yellow boundary, which is what's going to show up on the Instagram feed, and make sure that that's going to look good. All the text and the images and everything that we want to show up on our Instagram profile is within that yellow section, and then you can remove it and download your image as a PNG. Keep in mind the grid lines are not going to appear in your design. We then want to head over to pinetools.com/split-image and choose the file that we've just created. We want to split it up horizontally into blocks of 5 because that's how we set up the template, and split that image, download all those images, and then jump on over to our phone so that we can look at posting this on Instagram. So once the images are on our phone, we would go over to post, and then making sure we're selecting multiple and selecting them in the right order as well, that's key. Select all our images and then go to next. And I would obviously put in my caption, but for the time being, I'm just gonna share it so we can have a look at how the carousel looks. And that's turned out really nice. It doesn't have these weird glitches or overlaps that sometimes you see with carousels that aren't set up correctly as a design document. So I'm happy with that, and hopefully your carousels turn out just as great as this one. That's it for today's video on how to create beautiful Instagram carousel posts within Canva. I hope you liked the video. If you did and wanted to give it a like and subscribe to the channel so I can keep on providing you with more useful tutorials just like this one, that would be amazing. Thank you so much, guys, for being here, and I'll see you in the next video.